Hey everybody, welcome to the channel.
In this video, I'll be showing how to use Orca Slicer to print foaming lightweight PLA with not just bamboo printers, but any printer to print lightweight airplanes that can fly like this. Thanks for watching, please like and subscribe, and check out our website for this model and others, as well as printing configurations for different materials. My current printer of choice is the Bamboo Lab X1C, but just about any printer can print the foaming lightweight PLA. Hyperspeeds are not necessary, and the best results are printing one part at a time. The print settings are key to get any printer to print these parts well with this material. Orca Slicer works well with the new generation printers as well as the older generation printers. If you're using a Bamboo Lab X1C, P1S, or A1, you can go to our website and download the configuration files and import them, and they will show up in the user presets for filament and process, but only for the specific bamboo printer. Orca is compatible with many printers. However, if you choose a different printer, these custom presets will be hidden. Unfortunately, Orca Slicer and Bamboo Studio tie their filament and process settings to a specific printer type, and even the custom filament section is limited to just the bamboo printers. Hopefully they'll fix this in the future. This makes sharing filament and process settings difficult, but there is a way. If you have a different printer that is supported by Orca Slicer, you can transfer the relevant settings with this method. If you haven't done so already, find your printer in the Orca Slicer printer selection section. Confirm, and it will then load under the printer tab on the left. If your printer is not supported by Orca Slicer, it is possible there is something very similar to it. And many of the older Bedslinger printers can run with an Ender 3 generic profile. Once again, under the printer tab, go to Select Remove Printers. Select the Bamboo Lab X1C with the 0.4 nozzle and hit Confirm. Import the configuration files from the SoarKraft website for the filament and process for the X1C. And then they should show up in the pull down tab under User Presets. Launch another session of the Orca Slicer and put it side by side and set one to the Bamboo X1C with the lightweight filament and process, and the other to the printer you want to use, and select the generic PLA and the draft process. You'll be setting up both a new filament and a new process for the new printer. Let's start with the filament. Now you can click on the filament editor in each window and transpose the lightweight X1C filament settings to the generic PLA, changing the relevant settings in the first three tabs. Here are the specific filament settings for the foaming lightweight PLA. These first settings are all about the foaming. E-Sun, Bamboo Arrow, Sane Smart, and ColorFab foaming PLAs all foam similarly at these temperatures and flows. Reducing flow ratios to 0.5 or 50% and increasing nozzle temperatures to 250. A slightly elevated bed temperature helps with bed adhesion. And max volumetric speed is not very high, somewhere between 6 and 10. Under the cooling tab, I typically adjust the min and max fan speed threshold due to the very short layer times. Some heat in the layers helps with layer adhesion. And I still keep on the slowing for better layer cooling. Under the settings override tab, my airplane parts use retractions. I set retraction values as shown for the foaming material. some retraction, Z-hop but zero height, normal Z-hop, fast retractions, travel distance threshold, and wipe distance. One of the nice settings that Orca Slicer carried over from PrusaSlicer is extra length on restart, or prime. By adding 0.1 to 0.3 can eliminate the cheese grater effect of under extruding at the beginning of an extrude move. This can alleviate the problem of an underperforming extruder or difficult material to make a good part. It can also augment a lower flow ratio to get the lightest parts possible. But that takes some experimentation to get right. Also, under the first tab for filament, there is a pressure advance that you can enable. And in Orca Slicer, there's a whole calibration setup for this, and takes a little effort to get it set up right. The final three tabs are more based on what your specific printer needs for start and end G-code, multi-material, and any additional notes. After making all these changes, don't forget to save it under a new name. And it will show up in Filament User Presets. Now do the same thing with the Process tab, transposing the lightweight settings from the X1C to the Draft 2.4 layer process of the new printer. The Quality tab has the majority of the settings that need to be changed. The SoarKraft parts are designed around a 0.24mm layer height and a line width of 0.4mm. Set seam position to back. Under precision, set the slice gap closing radius to 0.001. Sometimes I set the resolution to 0.001, but it doesn't seem to have any effect. Check arc fitting on. These slow down the slicing, but are well worth it. Wall generator should be set to Arachne without having to change any of the other settings. Set the wall printing order to outer before inner and leave the rest the same. We will be coming back to the wall loop direction because that is a really cool new feature. And, of course, for the foaming material you want to have avoid crossing walls turned on, which increases travel time, but really helps with ooze control. Now, under the Strength tab, make sure there are three wall loops. And I usually have the infill density set to around 100, but for the lightweight material, anywhere between 30 and 100 is fine. Infill wall overlap should be set to 50. And the rest can be default. And now for the speed tab. Most printing is done at the outer wall speeds, but I still set all of my speeds to the same value. A little lower for the first layer, and anywhere between 45 and 65 has worked well with the Bamboo X1C. Older printers may need to print slower, such as 20 millimeters per second. The foaming material needs time to expand, so the speed is material limited. Acceleration is where you'll get most of the reduction in print times with the new generation printers. Maximizing travel speeds also reduces some of the stringing issues. Set these values to what your printer is capable of. Don't use support, so make sure that's turned off. And then other has your bed adhesion. Sometimes I like to turn the outer brim only on to help with bed adhesion. And then there is the special mode section that has some settings that might be of use for other file sets or printer issues like the printing sequence that I used on the Bamboo A1 to set it by object to slice without showing the time-lapse travel move. And here is the vase mode button. Again, save it under a new name, and it should show up in the process user presets for your printer. Now you can import and print the SoarKraft test part and try out the settings. Once you're happy, you're ready to print the rest of the plane. Oops, I almost forgot to talk about one of my favorite new features of Orca Slicer. Orca Slicer has a wall loop direction setting. Most slicers that I have used run the nozzle counterclockwise to the part, regardless of part shape. And even though a part is a mirror image right and left, they don't print that way. Like this example, the travel path is longer and outside the skin. Changing the setting to be clockwise changes the path to match the original part and will slice the same. Most users might not care, but when you're setting up complex print paths with the shortest travel moves possible, this will be very handy. Or if you're a perfectionist and want your mirrored right and left parts to be identical, this is the way to do it. In Orca Slicer, you can import multiple parts, turn parts on and off, set up the print bed, slice, and send each part individually. You can set the whole plane up in one location, on multiple build plates, even though you're printing one part at a time. In the project, you can switch between build plates, change materials, and even switch type of printer almost seamlessly. And you can output the G-code in many ways, even saving it to a file or SD card. The printer is now a tool, spitting out whatever airplane parts you want. And then you can save the project so you can come back to it anytime. But there is a quirk. Don't just hit the save button. Make sure you use save as, so it'll prompt you to give it a name. Otherwise, it'll just call it the same name as the first part you imported. And if you want to close before you saved, the program will ask you if you want to save, but does not let you choose a name. And it again defaults to the file name of the first part you imported. This is another thing that I hope they fix in the future. Check out our other videos for more Orca Slicer tips and tricks for printing airplanes. As well as how to build and set up flyable RC airplanes such as the Pika, that can fly like this. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.